Over the course of the past month, you've seen me create iconic, legendary fast food restaurants like McDonald's and Burger King in Animal Crossing, and have seen my Animal Crossing villagers get jobs at these places and see what kind of drama goes down when they work at fast food places. Today, Taco Bell joins the fray. Owned by Marshall, it's going to be legendary. And according to my YouTube comments, like Zucker and Marshall have internet beef or something. So I thought it'd be funny if we had Marshall working the counter and Zucker cooking the food. And we have this guy. What's this guy doing here just singing and dancing? In the year 1976, Animal Crossing icon Tom Nook sneezed. Animal Crossing doctors took the sneeze to the lab because they believed it was radioactive. Then, 44 years later, this radioactive, mutated sneeze became a human. Hosted in 10 refrigerators, surrounded by candles, a legend was born. George Goober. He is the most legendary Animal Crossing builder of all time, and today he's going to help Marshall build a brand new Taco Bell. I can bet a lot of money you didn't expect that to happen, did you? Anyways, we have a lot of work to do. George Goober, an original Animal Crossing Pikachu creation, is a legend. He is like the Bob the Builder of Animal Crossing, but 44 years old and created via sneeze. With that said, we have a lot of work to do, folks. Look at all these flowers. This is the terrain we have. This is the land we're working with. To the left of the Burger King, which is to the left of McDonald's. It's like the best strip mall of amazing Animal Crossing fast food restaurants. Anyways, so many flowers, so much digging. I put a lot of work into this. As you can see, Goober has really put it in the bicep muscles today. I mean, I am like feeling for him with all that shoveling. Anyways, we're putting flowers in trash bins. It's very, you know, I'm not good at being relaxing. I'm not that type of YouTuber, you know, I'm not like, we then walked and, you know, there's some pink flowers I had to dig. No, I have to be at a 10 at all times. That's just who I am. So, Goober, no, Goober! Goober worked the shovel a little too hard. It broke, it snapped in half. I had to go buy new shovels. So Goober is now really, I think it's just in his DNA. He can just like take down all of these mountainscapes. And it's snowing now, the snow is picking up, which I just think looks so cute. And I was really enjoying the time I had making these beautiful, 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 beautiful landscapes for this future Taco Bell. I'm destroying cliffs. I'm really just like the man of the hour. I'm going to Animal Crossing and telling Tom Nook that I'm gonna make Animal Crossing history. I'm like Debbie Ryan when she went to Disney headquarters and said she wanted to make Disney history. I am going to make Animal Crossing history with this Taco Bell. So I'm now adding terracotta. I think it's a very classy, beautiful flooring that really brings out, you know, lavish lifestyles. I really feel like my Animal Crossing villagers will feel like they're dining at a five-star restaurant if there's terracotta involved. So I'm finishing up the terracotta. I put the stone fencing. It just did not look well, did not mesh well, but I didn't want the same Zen fencing that the other two restaurants had. So I went with this one, and I felt like it went very, very well. It's blue. Taco Bell has some blue, and when you go in the store, it's like blue and purple. I feel like it fit with the color scheme. It looked really, really nice, and I really laid it out so it was kind of like a walkway to order your food. Like, it kind of guided you to the stall. I thought, you know what, if we're making Animal Crossing history, we can't do it with just a little bit of land. I have to go there and I have to break more bricks. Goober, get to work. It's time. You are so powerful, so amazing. You got this, Goob. George Goober, everyone. Round of applause for George Goober. So, George is doing a great job, you know, making history. And I thought, okay, stone background. This is where we're going to put, you know, like the furnace. This is where we're going to put the greasy fryers that they fry the tacos in and all that jazz. You know, really just amazing food being made here at Taco Bell. So here's the great thing we really have. I found this beautiful purple and blue tile that looks like the same tile that you go inside a taco. I mean, who else was a child, went to Taco Bell, said, this flooring is a lot of fun. Whoa, that was me. I love the Taco Bell flooring. So I thought it really had to be a big moment here on my Animal Crossing Taco Bell. If you look at it, it might hurt your eyes if you stare at it a little too much. It's a lot. It's a lot to take in. It's a very, it's a very, very maximalist pattern. There's a lot going on. I thought, you know what? I kind of want the terracotta to still play a role. We still gotta have a little bit of fanciness in here. You know, this is kind of looking like a clown. You know, this is looking like a clown car. So I have to add a little bit of nice terracotta brick. And I add more fence to make a divide between the eating area and the cooking area. Because you don't want people to make tacos right in front of you while you're eating tacos. Unless, you know, you're going to Chipotle or Qdoba, then that's fun. So Sherry, I don't know what's happening. She's like, I just don't like saying yeah, yeah. And I'm like, okay, what a fake Ariana Grande fan you are. So I gave her an even better Ariana Grande catchphrase. I gave her thank you next. A classic, you know, number one hit single, number one album, you know, Grammy nominated like 9 times. Duh, who wouldn't want to have the catchphrase thank you next? I wish my catchphrase could be thank you next. People just have to keep on saying it now. So anyways, Sherry's now happy. She's like, bam, I got it. That's great. Thank you for the catchphrase. I can now officially say I'm standing outside the local Animal Crossing Taco Bell. I don't think many people can say that. I'm very proud of my Taco Bell that lives in my area. With that said, I'm now putting up this beautiful Taco Bell painting. And a lot of people ask me, Nico, how'd you get that Van Gogh painting in your Taco Bell? It's beautiful. I'm like, wasn't Van Gogh. Thank you very much. Lots of compliments. You can go to the Able Sisters and type in Taco Bell. You can get it too. But thank you very much. I really think that's a testament to my quality. So I think the Taco Bell is just looking great. But now it's time for actual Animal Crossing gameplay. And then bam, of course, the one time I try to get wood, you know, bees come out and start, you know, it's really scary. I'm having like a panic attack. I'm like throwing my controller across the room. I'm like, ah! To do, I panicked and I didn't even attempt to run. You know, I took a few steps to the right and then I just gave up. And then I thought, you know what, it kind of looks good on this character. Like George Goober kind of makes, you know, I should feel like the swollen eye just, you know, fits his aesthetic in ways I just can't describe. With that said, I actually have to play Animal Crossing now, and I hunt. I didn't show you the hour it took me to get all this wood, but I did make enough wood for the rest of my island, my Taco Bell, and it looks really nice. I got this beautiful stall. It really looks like a piece of modern art. I mean, some people, like I said, first they thought, oh, is that Van Gogh? Now they're like, maybe not Van Gogh. Was it Pablo Picasso? I'm like, no. It's Able Sisters, folks. It's Able Sisters. So beautiful, beautiful snow. I'm seeing Zucker and Eric just hanging out. I'm like, Zucker, it's time to, you know, cook for your restaurant. You're the prime chef of the most deluxe restaurant in town. And he gives me medicine for my bee sting. And I thought that was like the nicest thing ever. Like, I don't really have many people to talk to in real life nowadays with the current circumstances we are in. So when Zucker randomly gave me medicine for my eye, I was like, wow. There's still happiness in this world. There's still kindness. Wow, I was like really taken aback. Marshall and Zucker are now officially inside the Taco Bell. This is their joint effort. It's two bros making a restaurant together. A very, very inspiring story of two friends making a restaurant together. Two enemies who have become friends. And especially, I mean, this is really an Oscar-worthy picture. That's what we're seeing right in front of us right now. So very nice. It looks really cute. They have their hats on. It's snowing and they're in front of Taco Bell. Who doesn't like a good wholesome Animal Crossing moment? I placed down some diner chairs that I really think would fit with Taco Bell. I put only these like purplish pink diner chairs because I think they really fit the Taco Bell aesthetic. We have a conversation between Zucker and Marshall. Let's listen on in. You know, I'm really happy that their gut instinct was to think about food. It really proves to me that they're serious about this Taco Bell process. So good for them. Good for them. Two bros just making a restaurant. So I'm now going to make this a lot prettier. So the outside connecting these three restaurants is not good enough. I think it could really be connected. You know, when you go to a strip mall and it's like restaurant after restaurant, store after store, I kind of want to get that vibe going. And maybe later we can do some really cool stuff and make stores in our Animal Crossing shopping district. So if you have any ideas for future future stores I can open that aren't restaurants but actual stores. Comment down below. Maybe we can do, you know, some type of Target, some type of Walmart, something like that. That could be really fun too. So it can just be one very long shopping center on my island. That could be a lot of fun. We actually see Zucker and Marshall talking in the corner. These buds just can't stop talking. I thought they were enemies. What happened? So beautiful terracotta, what can I say? Terracotta, terracotta, terracotta. Say it three times and I just feel fancier already. So beautiful, beautiful patterns happening here. Finally, all of these restaurants feel like they're connected. In just a little bit, I'm gonna have all of the villagers go to Taco Bell and see what they think of the local Taco Bell. And then at the end of this video, we're going to have my villagers decide who their favorite restaurant is. I say who as if they're like McDonald's is a person. I take McDonald's very seriously, I'm sorry. So, lots of fun things happening still to come in this video. So Marshall and Zucker are still talking about food. Again, I'm very happy that's all that's on their mind. Very relatable. So they're talking about how for lunch yesterday, he had a layered tomato sauce paste. I don't know. Zucker is like, all I eat is cheese pizza. And I'm like, finally, some relatable content. Marshall's talking about how he's like, he eats gourmet of gourmet. I'm like, okay, let's humble ourselves here. We're making Taco Bell food. We're not like in a five-star chef. Okay, so Marshall, calm down a little bit. I'm now adding some fencing. I thought, you know, I add more structure to this very elegant strip mall of very deluxe restaurants. So finally, it's a party. Woo, 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 it's a party. Put your party music on. It's in the middle of a cold winter day. I don't think anyone wants to, like, eat at an outside Taco Bell. It's not, like, the most opportune time to eat Taco Bell in the middle of a snowstorm outside. You're gonna get some snow flakes inside your, you know, cheesy gordita crunch. That might not be the best taste that you want to add. I do want to add that my parents literally asked me like 30 minutes ago what I wanted from Taco Bell while I was editing this video. And I said nothing. I'm not that big of a Taco Bell fan, I'll be honest. I love Mexican food, but Taco Bell, that just isn't my thing, which feels like this whole video is kind of like a falsity now. Anyways, Bam and Pom Pom are talking about workout routines. Pom Pom's like, I don't have any. Relatable duck. What a relatable. She's so relatable for being a duck. Bam's like, how do you look so buff? Call me. Okay, who here is walking around saying Pom Pom looks buff? I don't know what Bam is seeing in things. Why is he lying to people? So, anyways, Bam's talking about how you're looking really trendy. How do you do it? Yeah, yeah, I forgot they're still talking in Ariana Grande language. I love it. So, anyways, Pom Pom's talking how she might be buff tomorrow, might be trendy today. So, she likes to be called buff sometimes, but not all the times. Pom Pom's a very, very elusive character. I don't know how to describe her. She has many layers like an onion. Now she's yelling at him for calling her biceps trendy. It's just a lot. Pom Pom's a lot, and that's why I like her. She's just a lot. A lot's going on with Pom Pom always. So Ketchup, we have not heard from Ketchup once. I don't think Ketchup has an opinion on Taco Bell. She's just kind of like observing. She's a very introverted person. She's keeping her feelings to herself. I respect that. Anyways, we have a conversation between Marshall and Bam. These two, I just feel like, are one. Marshall and Bam are talking about what best island style is, and Bam's talking about how, like, his clothes have to be fully functional as gym clothes at all time, which I feel like is a little too much. I feel like you can have your gym clothes, but every single piece of clothing you wear has to be, like, ready to take a full lunge and, like, do some weightlifting. I don't know. That's a little too much for me, Bam. Anyways, I don't know if people are really enjoying this Taco Bell. I think the only person enjoying this Taco Bell is Marshall himself, who is doing this super cute little dance in the snow, which is just so adorable. But everyone else just kind of seems uninterested with this Taco Bell. No one's sitting down. Pom Pom and Zucker keep like weirdly like attacking each other. Like they keep seeing, just watch. They're like constantly on the brink of like pulling up a fist, or in this case, like a tentacle and a beak. They're like ready to have a beak and tentacle fight at any moment. Pom Pom's now asking us what type of song she would be. Marshall thinks she'd be some type of sad breakup song. I do not see that in the slightest. Marshall just doesn't know Pom Pom enough at all. Not one bit. So she asked me what I think, what song, you know, she should make. I think a catchy pop song. Duh. She should make a bop. Pom Pom is definitely a bop maker. So she's like, you're right, I'm a pop diva. And Marshall's like, is pop diva a thing? Because divas are usually solo artists backed by studio musicians and dancers. I'm like, this guy always has a comment about something. And category pop star includes boy bands, teen idols. I'm like, Marshall. Yeah, I agree with Pom Pom. Why are you trying to Marshall-splain this to us? I'm like, he's getting a little on my nerves. Marshall, wow. Anyways, the next day comes. I put on this beautiful burger McDonald's outfit. Blue Bear tells me Apple's sick and I should go check on her. We'll resolve that conflict later. I'll bring her some soup. But here's my favorite part of the entire video. I now put all of my Animal Crossing villagers in the middle of these three restaurants and see which one they're most attracted to. Bam doesn't really seem too interested in any of them just yet. I think he's thinking like, I don't know what I want today. Do I want a Big Mac? Do I want a Doritos Locos Taco? Chicken fingers from Burger King? And I think, I don't know, the Whopper seemed to attract him. I think 1 point goes to Burger King. Let's see what Blue Bear is attracted to. She's going near the McDonald's, but also going near an exit. Oh, wow, she is fully in on McDonald's. We have 1 point for McDonald's, 1 point for Burger King, 0 points for the newly built Taco Bell. Maybe PR around the island hasn't been too strong for the local Taco Bell. Maybe Marshall needs to expand the menu to address many more different palates, like maybe a vegetarian option. I don't know. We'll have to see what happens there. We now have Eric. Eric seems very interested in the menu that Burger King is presenting. Very smart. Burger King, the only restaurant on the island that has the menu right in front of the actual building. And that seemed to draw in Eric. Eric is all in on Burger King. Wow, 2 points for Burger King. I now thought, you know what, I had enough fun. Let's go check on Apple. Let's get her some medicine. I felt like, you know, really had to pay it forward. Zucker gave me some medicine. I should do the right thing. Get Apple some medicine. And now she feels great. Or I guess less gross. I was wondering where she was this whole entire episode. She seems like she always likes to be in the middle of everything. So I was like, why is she not at the local Taco Bell? Anyways, the rest of my villagers did not want to go out and do this thing today, so I waited till the next day, and Isabel's talking how it's a snow day. Oh my gosh, I was so excited to see snow finally on the ground in Animal Crossing, and here we go. It's beautiful. Oh my gosh. So personally, I am not the biggest fan of the season winter. I really don't like the cold, but I love snow and I think snow visuals are so cute and so pretty and I love looking at snow. So anyways, Zucker is here and Zucker is looking like he's paying attention to this McDonald's. Or is he just gonna leave? I can't tell. That is an option too. Picking none of them is an option. But no, he runs straight through the ketchup flowers and goes straight into McDonald's and sits down. Oh, we have a sitter. Oh my gosh, we haven't had someone sit down yet. That is epic. Now we have Pom Pom, who's the last animal we'll have testing today. We have 2 points for Burger King, 2 points for McDonald's. She could be the final vote, but it seems like she is just walking around, having herself a good time. I think if I opened up a Target or Walmart, that's more of Pom Pom's speed. She likes talking about clothes, not really about food. The lazy villagers, they like to talk about food. The peppy villagers like to talk about clothes and buying things. So she has her purse out, just so happy walking around. It actually is really cute. It looks like she's running straight to the Burger King, and no, she did a full 180. And now I think she might be leaving. She's either gonna go to McDonald's or completely leave. And we'll see in any second now what her choice is. She left. She says, I don't want any fast food today. What are you doing to me? Why are you trying to make me eat fast food? I'm like, okay, I get it. You can go. Enjoy your night. So the choice is now yours in the comment section. Comment down below, which restaurant is your favorite on my island? I want you to judge it based on what they look like, how well the restaurant is made, which people, you know, how good the staff was, all that kind of stuff. Put everything into consideration, and whichever one gets the most amount of votes will probably stay the longest in this strip mall. I might tear down a McDonald's once in a while or tear down Taco Bell, but whichever one you all seem to like the most is the one that will stay the longest. Also, make sure to comment down below which one of restaurants I should make next. I'm really open to anything as long as it fits with Animal Crossing. I could add Target, a Walmart, a Meijer. I could add, you know, Amazon. I don't know. Anything you want. Comment down below. I'm listening to your ideas, and I'm really excited to make more stuff on my Animal Crossing island. And I'm so happy it's finally snowing. So thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more videos just like this. You can keep watching videos of me making things on my island like McDonald's and Burger King right in front of you. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later.